What's up, guys? Wally here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, I want to talk about why SQL seems so hard to learn for most aspiring data analysts. You know, having sat down with a couple of aspiring data analysts, the one thing that seemed to be fairly common is the struggle to get a hang of SQL. And while I know that SQL is one of the easiest languages to learn, the concepts, the syntax, and the queries are easy to remember, it is quite strange that people find it difficult and oftentimes appear lost as to how to write SQL scripts. So people often ask, how do I know when to use certain functions? Will I have to memorize all of them? And how long will I need to learn for? So as you may already know, SQL, also known as SQL, is a programming language that is used to communicate with a database. And this communication is done in form of scripting using normal everyday English language. Now, with your script, you can update a database with new information or extract existing information from a database. Meanwhile, a database is a place where data is stored, and databases are also of two types. You have relational database and non-relational database. In a relational database, data is stored in tables, and a table simply comprises of rows and columns of data. To better understand this, let's think of a library. We all know what a library is. A library is a place where books are kept. And in this case, for this example, we can say database equals library. Now, in a library, books are not just stacked randomly, right? They are arranged orderly in shelves. Shelves are made of rows and columns. Hence, we can say shelves equals tables. And finally, books are stored in shelves, so book equals data. In using this analogy, what we have done is to substitute the knowledge we're trying to acquire with an existing knowledge that we already have to make what we're trying to learn stick. And this has proven to be one of the fastest ways to learn concepts, and one that I use repeatedly during the course of learning SQL. So in finding something that you already know and substituting it with the SQL concepts that you are learning, would that make it easier for you to grasp? Can we find a way to relate the functions in SQL to the function in, say, for example, Excel? Let's take a look at a few of the functions used to extract information from a database, specifically with respect to viewing data, sorting data, filtering data, joining tables, and conditional statements. Now, to view data in SQL, you have to use the select statement, which basically is the statement that you write to tell the database what you are looking for. So if you say select asterisk from table A, what you are saying in effect is return all column values from table A to view. There are many variations to this. You could also write the select statement and list out only the columns you want to view. That will also be appropriate. The from statement is you stating the table where you will find the information you want to view. Just like we do in real life when we're looking for something, we have to know where the item that we're looking for is. So you have to tell the computer where to find the information you are looking for. And for you to know where the information is, you have to be familiar with all the tables within your database. You have to know what information they contain and how they are linked to other tables. When it comes to filtering data, the where statement is what is used. The where statement is where you start putting conditions to your search. You know what you're looking for, you know where to find it, but you have other criteria that you want to consider in your search. Using the library analogy, where you want to find books that are written by a particular author or that was published within a certain time period, essentially filtering your results. The same way we apply filters on Excel, only this time, instead of clicking and dragging, you're writing it as a line of script. The last two functions I want to mention are joins and conditional statements. Now, because there are usually many tables within a database, it is necessary to be able to link one table to another, and linking of a table is only possible with the use of keys. Keys can be of two types. You have primary keys and foreign keys. Primary keys are the unique identifier of a table, while foreign keys is a key that creates a relationship between two tables. Why do we need keys? We need keys because we may need to perform complex search operations within a database. And because there are multiple tables within a database, we can join these tables together with the help of keys. So using a join statement is you taking one or more tables and joining them in a way that you can analyze the data from them. The closest function that illustrates this in Excel is the VLOOKUP function. This involves joining two data sets or tables with a common key, and that key is your lookup value. The last statement I'm going to talk about is the conditional statement, the case statement. The case statement is used to invoke a condition so as to set a predetermined output. When A equals B, which is the condition, then C, else show D. Exactly how an if statement works in Excel. Conditional statement can be used to perform many complex analyses needed to produce reports. But what is also interesting about case statements in SQL is that you can use aggregate functions with your case statements, same way we use some ifs and count ifs in Excel. Frankly, I'm one of those people who believe that once you understand Excel functions, learning SQL functions becomes very easy. It will be a shame if you know how to write SQL scripts and you don't know how to use VLOOKUP or conditional statements in Excel. So I think you get the picture now. If you are already good in Excel, learning SQL should be a lot easier and faster. The rest of the functions, especially those with respect to extracting information from the database, we may not be able to cover those ones in this video. But what I want to stress is, as you are learning the key concept in SQL and as you solve practice problems, try to imagine how you will solve that problem in Excel. Most likely, you will get a better understanding of how to solve the problem. If in solving the problem, you need to apply a filter, then you know that you must write a where statement. If you have to use some if or count ifs to solve the problem in Excel, then it means you need to write a case statement and combine your case statement with an aggregate function. You can check out the LearnSQL platform to learn more about SQL and attempt practice questions. In case you didn't know, I did a review of the platform in my last video. If you want to check it out, I'll leave links to the video in the description below. Finally, I just want to encourage everyone out there grinding it and trying to learn these things. I want you to know that you are on the right path and it just takes time to become fully aware and gain mastery. But as long as you put in the work every day within the shortest possible time, you will be fine. All right, that's the video. If you got value out of this, do smash the like button. Don't forget to check learnsql.com for practice questions and quizzes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.